Hi guys, welcome to Easy Just Like That. So today we are going to see how to make a kaftan top. Now the cloth which I am using, most of you might be familiar with this. This is the scarf which was sent in the May month Lady Raga bag. I did not like the print at all, but to be used as a scarf, but then I thought that this print will be good for a kaftan style top. So that's why I have decided to use it as a kaftan top instead of using as a scarf, because it is very short for a scarf as well. So let's get started. Now I'm going to fold this like four times. How you can see that. Now I'm going to join the corners and I'm going to pin them together. So basically kaftan is very very easy to make. It won't take more than 5 minutes for you to do the markings and the cutting, and it won't take more than 5 to 10 minutes for the stitching. So it's the most simplest top which you can make. So let's pin this. Now the length of a kaftan is completely your choice. The kaftan style top can be made from the waist size till the ankle length. So it's one versatile type of dress which can be made very easily for any length, and it will look just perfect. So the length which I have got is just below, just till my knees. So the length of cloth which I have got in this scarf is till my knees. So that's it. So let me mark the neck first. So I'm going to mark 2.5 inches. This is for the back, and then I'm going to mark 3.5 inches towards the shoulder. Now this is going to be the neck. The neck at the top, like neck at the front or the back, length is completely your choice. You can take it more or less, but if you're taking too less, it will be difficult for you to get your head inside that opening. So make sure that the opening which you make is sufficient for you to wear it. So this is done. Now for the marking of your armpit, I'm going to make it a little bit loose. So I'm going to mark till my shoulder length, that is 6 inches, and from that part I'm going to calculate like 10 inches. Usually like 7 inches is what you take for a top, but for these kind of kaftans and all it should be free. So I have taken like 9.5 inches, and then there I'm going to mark it and take the length of your chest. So with that, just go ahead and add 2 more inches so that it will be very free. So instead of taking 10, I am marking at 12. So it will be very loose and airy, and it will be really good. You can just wear a spaghy inside and wear this top on it. It will look really nice. So this is the length. I'm not going to do anything with the length. I'm just going to mark the sides. Now in this we have to actually stitch from outside. The stitch which I'm showing will not go inside. It will be stitched on the top, so that when you're wearing the kaftan, the entire cloth will be visible just the same way. Now just do the cutting of the neck. That's it. This is the only cutting which we do in a kaftan, like your neck, that's all. And there are other type of kaftans also very new, like they are called actually abaya. If you want to have an opening at the front, they are called abayas. But in a kaftan there are no openings other than your neck. So I am going to pin the front part again, and I'm going to do a deeper cut for the front. Make sure you remove the other side. Now for the front, I am marking at 5 inches. I don't want it to be like too deep, so it should be like average. So I'm going to mark it at 2.5 more. So the neck was 2.5 already cut, and then I'm adding 2.5 more. So mark it. And let's cut it. Be very careful that the cloth is not like the back side of your kaftan should not be like should be kept aside. Make sure you don't cut that cloth. Alright, you're done. So people like me who are wondering what to do with this kind of scarves which you got in your Lady Raga bag, this is the best thing you can do. So I'm going to pin down the cloth at the armpit opening so that I can have a reference for stitch. Let me pin the bottom layer also. That's it. So this is how our kaftan is going to look like. Okay, let's stitch it now. So the bottom layer is very simple. I'm just going to fold it twice and then lock it. You can do a simple zigzag or a picot, but I think this way the cloth will stay at the place so that it will add some weight to your bottom of your top. So I'm going to just fold it twice and then lock it. So that's it. Like this we are going to stitch both the sides. Now I'm going to stitch the neck. So for neck I have decided to do the zigzag or picot to lock the cloth instead of like adding extra cloth, because this is the most simplest way of stitching a kaftan I want to show you. So I'm not going to add any cloth here. I'm just going to picot the neck. Since it is a circle, it will be very easy for you to do the picot. And instead of doing just one layer, I'm going to do the picot twice. So this is the second time. Again, I'm stitching on the picot so that it will be like two times locked. And it will look a bit broad and it will give support to your cloth. If you do only once, the cloth will not have support and it might tear apart if you put some pressure. So this is how the picot is going to look like, and it is going to be really really strong, and you don't have to worry about it getting torn. That looks really neat. Okay, so we are almost done. Now we are going to remove the picot bottom, and then I'm going to add the normal stitching. Now let's stitch the sides of the top. That's it. Since we have pinned the cloth already, it will be easy for us to, you know, do the stitching. Just lock it at the armpit and then stitch it along the marking which you have made. That's it. Very simple, very easy to make, and it looks really nice also. You know, this kind of kaftans look very nice with kind of georgette or silky type of cloths. Even cotton looks good. So this is one versatile pattern of making a top. So there is no restriction for the length of arms, no restriction for the length of your dress itself. That's it. This is how we are going to stitch both the sides, and our kaftan is ready. I hope you like this video. Please try this DIY at home, and please like, share, comment, and please do subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care and bye.